Good fortune of getting four of these Dell for supplies. These are for servers. Quite an interesting design. It just clips in here, pulls out as you press this down, and you can just eject it straight from the server. So it's an interesting little design. Not sure how to put them on. A normal power supply is pretty easy, right? You just short the green and black wires. This, on the other hand, has a very, very big connector at the back. And obviously no wire colors, and this probably goes straight onto the board. So yeah, I did not get the other side of the cable for this plugs straight into a cable mount on the other side, and that would have been quite difficult to get out. So now comes the challenge of figuring out how to put this on. Hopefully there's some schematics or some information online to help me figure this out. There's a model number, so I want to open one just to start with and see if I can figure out what's inside, you know, if it's anything I can figure out from it. It's 16 amps on the 12 volts, 40 amps on the 5 volts. So yeah, some pretty high amperages, but then again, not really that dissimilar from what you would get on an ordinary computer power supply. The thing is, with four identical power supplies, maybe I can put them together and try to generate the welding that I want to do. Inside the power supply, I managed to get it open. Couple connectors have to disconnect here. I'll have to find those back, but they seem fairly easy enough to find. These are voltage comparators, and there are quite a few of them. So yeah, that most likely is a 400 volt capacitor. This is probably the most dangerous sign, probably best to keep out of that. Really, not sure what that is, probably a MOSFET. These are possibly the rectifiers on this. Let me see, is that visible at all? Yeah, there. Possibly the rectifiers there. Right, not sure what this one is. There's actually a name, model number, it appears too. So I'll have a look at that and see if I can get any information. But let me just take this whole thing off, turn it around, and see if I can figure out what's going on. Because just directly measuring, I'm getting some answers. I'm getting this thing to come on, I'm getting the fan to come on this one, and I'm getting the light to come on with two independent things. I cannot put both of them on at the same time, and neither one of them am I getting proper voltage coming out on anything. There's the standby voltages that I'm getting, nothing else I'm getting good proper voltages to work with. So clearly figuring out how to put this on is a little bit more complex than I initially thought. On the side of that board, mostly some tantalum caps, some diodes, and some resistors. Pretty much passives all the way here, nothing in the way of integrated circuits. Again, if we look at this one, just comparators. We look at this, just comparators. I'm not seeing a microcontroller anywhere so far, so it seems to suggest that this thing is a person, is really just pretty much analog logic. These two pins here are the two that I'm getting a voltage on without the power supply, you know, being turned on. Once you plug in, you get a voltage on them, around 5 volts on both of them. This one goes down. Let me put this down carefully. Right. That is, sorry, these two here. That one goes, the trace goes on top, and we look back at that. This one, the trace comes through, and who knows where it's going. It all appears to be going to this transformer here. Let me put it up now. Right. So what happens, that is that trace there, which comes along here. Let me see if I can kind of edge. Yeah. Comes along here, comes here, and then docks in underneath this. I don't know where it's going after that. I could probably try to find it. Not sure it will help me that much, but pretty much those are the only two I'm getting voltages on. And they seem to be pretty much to with some control to them. Question is, how do I get that to work? Again, just running through basics of design, what they've done is they've basically put a lot of solder on these to get the actual carrying capacity increased, because Of course, the copper mask is probably fairly thin and not capable, and putting a larger copper mask would then, of course, hamper your layout. So, yeah, typical design, typical of wool analog stuff. This is how wool analog stuff always looks. So, yeah, not too bad. I don't think I'm really that much closer to figuring anything out, but haven't opened it. But it was worth a look. Quickly jump into this. Looking at the rear of the power supply, taking my numbering from that way, from left to right, obviously top, bottom, numbering this way. What I've figured out so far, push this back a little bit, right, is from number 4 to number 10, that's 5 volts. This one is connected to something, not sure what. This, 12 volts. This is connected to something, not sure what. 3.3 volts. All of this is ground. These two are connected to something, not sure what. These are, and these three are. This is the on. Ground this one, which is the first one on the lower end, to any of these ground, the power supply comes on. It's stable. I'll do this in a better format, and pretty much that translates to this here. But that isn't as useful to see this way. It's actually more useful looking at it this way. So that's top, left hand side number 1. I'll put that in a better graphic. If someone else gets a power supply like this, maybe they can, you know, use the information.